this box is the best-selling graphics card on AliExpress. Apparently, they've sold more than 10,000 of these, which is a lot. But unfortunately, it's not very good. And in today's video, we're gonna figure out just how bad it is and what you should buy instead. But what if you wanna make yourself the best-selling graphics card in all of the CV pile? Well, then you should try adding some new skills with today's video sponsor, Brilliant. Brilliant is where you develop skills by doing skills with thousands of interactive lessons in math, data analysis, programming, and AI. Instead of doom scrolling, why not try a daily interactive lesson in one of Brilliant's new data science courses, which uses real-world data to train you how to see trends and make better decisions. So try Brilliant for free for 30 days if you go to brilliant.org/Dawid, or scan the QR code or click the link down below. And you'll also get 20% off a premium annual subscription with Brilliant! Whoa, there is no information on this box. Apparently we got a Soyo Dragon graphics card. It's not even clear if it's an AMD or Nvidia graphics card. Oh yes, nothing like a quality guarantee card with a technical support email address that looks like a teenager's first Hotmail account. That's very reassuring. Although, look at that dragon watermark. Ooh. And then we have our very securely packaged graphics card. Oh, what a beauty. This is a Soyo. Look at that. It has a very strong fake GTS 450 vibe to it, but it doesn't have a Mesozoic period port on the back, so I think we're good, and price-wise, this very much makes sense for what it is, but we'll talk about that a bit later. But as you can tell, the heatsink is very rudimentary. It's just a bit of aluminium that they cut some grooves in for increased surface area, and then we have our little fan to cool it. But this should be plenty cooling, considering that this is an RX 550, a graphics card that's been out for a while. In fact, I'm pretty sure the Ottoman Empire was still a thing when this thing first came out. And it wasn't particularly quick when it was first launched, let alone 1800 years later. In fact, the RX 550 launched as an $80 graphics card at the bottom of AMD's discrete RX lineup. There were a couple of OEM-only cards that fell beneath it, but it was pretty lame back in 2017. In fact, this isn't even the full fat 640 SP version of the RX 550, it's a cut down one. So I am very curious to see how it holds up with modern games. Now to test this graphics card that's more popular than a dermatologist in Fallout, we need a system that has enough CPU power to keep up with the immense might of this little 550. And to do that, I've got a Ryzen 9 5900X with 16 gigs of DDR4 at 3200 megahertz. Okay, so that's a good start. We've got some video out. Now we just need to install drivers and then hopefully it's fine. It was fine. The driver install worked perfectly, except for it very passive aggressively showing thumbnails of games we probably can't play on this graphics card. Loading into CS2's menus, that's not a great start. This is 1080p low. I think it's low. Did I change it? Oh, no, we're not at low yet. That explains it. Okay, never mind. That's much better. Okay, so once you load into the game, it's going better than I was expecting, considering the menu performance or experience. Ooh, very big stutter. When it's not stuttering, it feels pretty good. Like, this is a usable esports experience at 1080p low settings. That occasional stutter is not great though. Okay, so now that the system's settled down a bit and it's not stuttering as much, the gaming experience has just crawled over that boundary of acceptable. Now with Fortnite at 1080p low settings with epic draw distance, while we're inside, we're getting, you know, 60 frames per second. It's borderline usable. I think it's the kind of thing that, oh. Sorry, I just had to clap some cheeks there. Yeah, it's usable, as you can tell, if you're playing against bots. You're gonna be able to survive. But Oh, this is not great. This really isn't great. And Fortnite is not a particularly demanding game. And then as you can see, our CPU is having to work its little butt off to keep up with the RX 550. Now with Dota 2, a game which I feel like I have to run on this graphics card because this is probably like SEA Dota the graphics card. Oh wow, it is crushing it. So even when lots of spells are happening, it's fine. Like it does drop down quite a bit, but this is usable. This is definitely a usable Dota experience. With PUBG at 1080p with everything very low except far draw distance, we're not getting a whole lot of frames here. Now again, with PUBG, the performance with this graphics card is just on the border of acceptable. It's been the case with all of the games so far. Yeah, it's actually kind of impressive how the system just manages to skirt that line of unplayability. But at least the temperatures are immaculate, look at that. But with that, let's see what happens when we try something a little bit more demanding. I can't imagine it's going to enjoy 1080p very much, but who knows, maybe it'll impress us. No, it doesn't enjoy it. 16 frames per second isn't great. And also, it looks kind of funky, almost like there's fidelity effects or something on, even though there isn't. On that note, let's turn it on and see how much that helps. I'm going to go to balanced. I mean, it did. 23. We are like, oh, we've got like an after image on the back of our car. This graphics card and Fidelity FX don't get along very well. So let's see what Ultra Performance does. Hey, would you look at that? 30 whole frames per second. It doesn't look great and it feels pretty terrible, but it's a lot better than 15. So now that we've established that the best-selling graphics card on AliExpress is an Olympic-tier athlete at minimum acceptable esports performance, I want to compare it to its own big brother, an equally old graphics card, the RX 580. This is a cut-down version, the 2048 SP, and it's a card that you can readily buy on AliExpress at the moment, not even for that much more money than the RX 550. I'm curious to see how these compare, although I'm not going to give this as an alternative graphics card because that price difference could still be prohibitive to a lot of people. So I have another graphics card I bought from AliExpress that costs a very similar amount to the 550, but should be a decent bit faster. But first... Whoa, that is a lot more frame rate. I mean, it makes complete sense. It's like comparing a Spitfire to a Wright Flyer, but still, that's a big difference. Ooh, we're still getting big stutters occasionally though. But aside from those, this is much better than just minimally acceptable. Oh yeah, now again with Fortnite, it's just running so much better. We're getting about 100 to 120 frames per second. I mean, even with lots of particle jizz effects going on here, it just drops to just under 100. With Dota 2, the difference wasn't as overtly humiliating as the first couple of tests, but when heavy particle effects started flying around, it would dip a lot less on the RX 580. PUBG also felt wildly less minimum acceptable gaming performance, which is good. And then finally, with Cyberpunk at 1080p low, again, just so much more frame rate. But the crazy thing to remember here is that these tests make the RX 580 look like a beast, but by today's standards, this isn't good Cyberpunk performance. This isn't something to aspire to, even though it looks so much better than that RX 550. I'm also curious if the 580 takes the Fidelity FX a bit better. It does. We don't have that weird after image with balanced Fidelity FX, so that's good. So big surprise there, an RX 580 is faster than an RX 550. But I still think it's a useful way to put the performance, or lack thereof, of the 550 into perspective. So now, let's see if I could find a graphics card that cost a similar amount to the 550, but performs better. And the answer is, well, another Soyo graphics card, which has the exact same box. So let's hope this is actually a different graphics card. Oh good, it is a different graphics card. In fact, it's an RX 470, which I paid a very similar amount for as that RX 550. But this should, performance-wise, be much more in line with the RX 580 2048 SP variant than it would be with the RX 550. Lots of numbers said there, which I guess means now we have to see how it performs. Oh, would you look at that? CS2 running about as well as it was running on the RX 580. This is 1080p CS2, and this is running about as well as you'd want it to run, unlike with the RX 550, where it's minimum, just bare minimum. This is just wildly more playable than the RX 550 is. The RX 550 is kind of like a GT 710 in that it's a graphics card that you use if you need video out, not if you want gaming to happen. Whereas this handles gaming way better. And the same was true for the other three games I tested as well. All of them saw the little RX 550 abandoned alone by the roadside like the least favorite sibling. And considering that you can buy the 470 for a very similar amount depending on when you buy it to the 550, it's pretty hard to argue for buying that 550. Maybe if you need a graphics card that doesn't require supplemental power? So with that, what did we learn in today's video? Well, apparently AliExpress buyers really need to stop buying the RX 550. Like, what are you doing? Subscribe to the channel if you want more videos like this one, and until the next video, bye-bye.